Good morning. In this class, we'll discuss about the stabilization methods of RF amplifier. So, stabilization of RF amplifier. The conditions for stability is that the magnitude of the reflection coefficient should be less than 1. That means magnitude of gamma n should be less than 1 and gamma out should also be less than 1. So, the expressions for gamma in, that is the reflection coefficient, can be written as Zin minus Z0 by Zin plus Z0. And also for the output reflection coefficient can be written as Z out minus Z naught by Z out plus Z naught. These two should be less than 1 for stability. For high stability, these, the magnitude of the reflection coefficient should be less than 1. Okay. So method of should be less than 1. So the method to stabilize the activated device is to suppose if we have this real part of Zn is less than 0. Consider this real part of Zn is less than 0. Say for example, so here it is minus 50 ohm. So suppose if we have minus 50 ohm, then minus 50 minus 20. Suppose this is minus, this is 20. So minus 50 minus 20 minus 70 by minus 50 plus 20 is minus 30. That means 70 by 30, you will be having some 2 point something. So that means it will be greater than 1. Okay. So if real part of Zn is less than 0, then we will be meeting this situation that gamma n should be, will be greater than 1. So but with the, for stability, this gamma n should be less than 1. So the real part of Zn, if goes less than 0, then we will be reaching the unconditional, we will be reaching the condition of instability. So to compensate that, what is the way, method is, we have to add a series resistance or a shunt conductance to the port. So the method is to add a series resistance or shunt conductance so that we can raise the input impedance greater than 0. Okay, so we can raise the input impedance to be greater than 0, and we can achieve gamma, we can achieve that, suppose this is positive, this is plus 50 minus 30 by 50 plus 30, 20 by 80, it will become some plus 0.25. So the it will be less than 1. So gamma, magnitude of gamma n will be less than 1. So we have to bring the condition that magnitude of gamma n should be less than 1. So for that, the method is we have to improve this impedance from negative value to positive value. So for this, the method is we can add a series resistance. We can add a series resistance to the port, or a shunt conductance to the port. Okay. So real part of Zn plus Rn dash plus, this is the extra additional resistance we are adding, plus Zs should be greater than 0, or real part of Yin plus Gin dash plus Ys should be greater than 0. This is indicated in this diagram. So we are adding a series resistance. So here we are adding a shunt conductance. So this is at the input port. So this is the input port source and the amplifier. Okay. So we are adding a series resistance or a shunt conductance. Similarly, we can stabilize at the output side. Stabilization of output port through a series resistance or a shunt conductance at the output port. In this way, we can achieve stability. Okay, thank you. Now the questions I am going to ask in this both sections, that is RF amplifier and stabilization methods, is differentiate amplifier design at RF and low frequency. So what are the conditions, what are the differences between amplifier design at RF and at low frequency? What are the requirements of amplifier design? Define transducer power gain. What do you mean by unconditional stability? What are the stabilization methods of RF amplifier? And the references for this section is RF circuit design theory and applications by Reihold, Ludwig and Pavel Brichko. Thank you all.